Those who want Australia to become a republic are today rejoicing, with the biggest step towards breaking away from the monarchy in nearly 25 years. The Albanese government swearing in an assistant minister to the republic, tasked with moving our country towards a referendum.
Sworn into the federal ministry.
I, Matthew James Thistlethwaite.
By the monarch's representative. Matthew Thistlethwaite becomes Australia's first assistant minister for the Republic.
It means that we can now begin a serious discussion about recognising Australia's independence, our maturity, and hopefully moving one day to having an Australian as our head of state.
Despite an unsuccessful attempt in 1999, previous Labor leaders have promised another referendum asking Australians whether we should break away from the British monarchy and become a republic. And while it wasn't an election promise, it seems the new government is gearing up to try again.
It fractures the nation, and this is not the time to be doing that.
We can do better than to find our head of state from a family of English aristocrats living in a palace in London.
But who would our head of state be if not the Queen? The model being proposed involves the Parliament in each state and territory nominating one candidate. The federal Parliament can nominate up to three. All Australians then vote and a winner gets a five-year term.
And you come up with 11 eminent people and you put it to the people, preferential voting system, who would you like? Very, very simple.
You remove the crown from our constitution and you're replacing it with a state controlled by politicians.
But history has shown changing the constitution is hard. It requires the majority of voters and the majority of states and territories to agree. That's only happened 8 times in Australia's history of 44 proposed changes. No word yet on when Australians might be asked to vote and which royal would be reigning by then. But the government's made it clear the Uluru Statement from the Heart is the first priority. Paris Martin for 10 News First.